Hello guys, this is Rich of Rich TV and welcome back to my channel, Matthew Falster, the Devotional guys. I would like to shout out to Paul and Prayer channel na napunta rito at na-join sa Devotional. Shout out and God bless to Leo Bacoteco, Juan Anthony Valmoria, SSC TV of Korea, Jusen Co Studio, Pimbert Tolpo, Retro Blog, Nanay Amakolda, Michael Aborita, Yance TV, Connie Blog, Formance Work, Heart Ponsalan, Mami Rose Croft, Friends, Shendog, Vin Lawrence Chonko, and Nathaniel Abilia. Shout out na rin sa mesudyante ko na bagong salta na mesudyante ko. No? Then my new student, both grade 11 and grade 12. God bless us all, guys. TV. Guys, nai-excite ba kayo every time we have our devotional? Ako guys, nai-excite ako kasi nga different stories, no. This is a real story na nangyari before, no. Nabasa na natin kung ano yung nangyari sa life ni Jacob, sa mga anak niya, no. And so on and so forth sa mga binasa natin kahapon. At this time, we'll read about Joseph's dream, no. Si Joseph, yung dreamer na anak ni Jacob. So ito yung pag-aralan natin ngayon. Okay guys, let's not proceed to devotional. Let's open our Bible to Genesis chapter 37 verses 1 to 11. Still guys, I'm using the devotional study Bible because the words you see so simplified maintindihan talaga natin. Okay, the word of the Lord in Genesis chapter 37 verses 1 to 11 says, Jacob lived in the land where his father had stayed, the land of Canaan. This is the account of Jacob. Joseph, a young man of 17, was tending the flock with his brother, the sons of Bilhah, the sons of Zilpah, his father's wives, and he brought their father a bad report about them. Now Israel loved Joseph more than any of his other son. Hindi na Jacob yung pangalan niya, Israel na, no? Because he had been born to him in his old age, and he made a richly ornamented robe for him. When his brothers saw that their father loved him more than any of them, they hated him and could not speak a kind word to him. Joseph had a dream, and when he told to his brother, they hated him all the more. He said to them, "Listen to this dream I had. We were binding sheaves of grain out in the field, when suddenly my sheaf rose and stood upright, while your sheaves gathered around mine and bowed down to it." His brother said to him, "Do you intend to reign over us? Will you actually rule us?" And they hated him all the more because of his dream. And that he said, when he had another dream, and he told it to his brother, "Listen," he said, "I had another dream, and this time the sun and moon and 11 stars were bowing down to me." When he told his father as well as his brothers rebuked him and said, "What is this dream you had? Will your mother and I, your brothers, actually come and bow down to the ground before you?" His brothers were jealous of him, but his father kept the matter in his mind. Amen and amen. I guess let's not pray. Like Joseph the dreamer of Ganak ni Israel or Jacob, many times we also dream. There are those dreams na nangyayari in reality, and there are those dreams na passive lang, okay. Lord, in our real life, we dream of something, particularly about isa sa amin, okay. We dream to have a peaceful life, masaganang buhay para sa pamilya at sa mga member ng pamilya, even to us, okay. This is the dream each one has, Lord God. A peaceful life, O God. orderly life, Lord God, na walang kaguluhan. Okay. Wow, Lord, ang saya-saya siguro. Okay. Lord, lead us, O God. Lead us, O God, to handle the dreams we have, that it will come to reality. Kasi yung dream ni Joseph, Lord God, really come to reality. Bless each one's dream, O God, nandito ngayon, O Lord God. Bless it, O God, and give it, Lord, and make it a reality. Amen and amen. Our focus verse for this evening, guys, is found in Genesis chapter 7, verse 2 and 5. It says, Joseph, a young man of 17, was tending the flock with his brothers, the son of Bilhah and the son of Zilpah, his father's wives, and he brought their father a bad report about them. Joseph had a dream, and when he told it to his brothers, they hated him all the more. So the title of our devotion for this evening, guys, is Dreams and Life. From the start, parental favoritism among Abraham's progeny promoted family discord, deception, and the disappearance of the preferred son, Ishmael and Isaac, Esau and Jacob, Leah, Zilpah, and Bilhah, and Rachel, and now Joseph and his brother. As far as the brothers were concerned, there were many reasons for their feelings towards Joseph. He wrote a bad report about them to Jacob, most likely on a regular basis. His father made him a richly ornamented robe, hardly like work clothes his brothers tore as they shepherded the flock. The odd result to the injured egos of the brothers, Joseph told them about two dreams which seemed to indicate that they and even Jacob would eventually bow in submission to him. This father incensed Joseph's brother and hated him. But really, the brother's jealousy and hatred towards Joseph was unjustified because of his preeminence was aligned with God's sovereign purpose. Nevertheless, God's grace intervened in order to achieve his goodwill. God's great power is at work in every circumstance to accomplish his good purpose. Joseph's dream did not go down well with his brothers. His father, who at first rebuked him, took the dream seriously. He kept the matter in his mind. Amen and amen. I remember one day during an international conference, religious conference, our speaker came near me and told me, Richard, I want to pray for you. And as he prayed, he prophesied, Richard, you will be the Joseph of your family. And I'm really so happy about it. Now at this time, I was reminded of the prophecy given to me. Because this is important. Yes, yung iba, jealous talaga sa mga dreams, like what happened to Joseph, sa mga brothers niya, no? Galit na galit sila. All the more sila nagalit because the favor was given to Joseph sa father nila na si Israel or Jacob. Guys, the Joseph's dream comes to reality. He become the governor of Israel, that is the second highest in command, the king and then siya. And during the famine, yun nakatotoo, no? That the siblings, tsaka yung father niya, nagbow down talaga kay Joseph because Joseph becomes somebody. Well, probably we will not bow down or people not bow down unto us. But there are those people who depended unto us. Okay, let's pray for our dreams to become a reality. No? Kasi my dreams talaga nagkakatotoo. We all have dreams and let's pray for it. Okay, guys, my question dito, what are your dreams for the future? And pray for God's leading. Yes, I know you have a dream. Keep praying about it. I also have my dream and I keep praying about it. No? Na magaya kay Joseph, na yung dream would come to reality. I guess let's not pray. Father God, honor our dreams, our aspiration in life, our ambition in life, let it come to reality. You have favored Joseph, and may your favor be also with us. Bless the work of our hands as we work hard in order to achieve our dreams. Anoint us, dear God, with your wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to have our dream come to reality. Amen and amen. Guys, I know you have dreams. Keep praying about that dream. And I know God will really honor the dreams and ambition and aspiration of life you have. God bless us all, guys, because I know God surely blesses 10 times better. This again, it's Priest TV. Kita-kita tayo muli. Tansang muli. Paalam!